Hi, my name is Anna O'Grady, and I'm a PhD student here at the Dunlap Institute. I study massive stars, and particularly yellow supergiants, and I'm really interested in how they evolve and eventually explode as supernovae. I'm also a queer astronomer. I'm asexual and aromantic. And since June is Pride Month, I wanted to tell you more about another member of the astronomical community who is also a massive, influential gay rights advocate. His name was Dr. Frank Kameny. Dr. Kameny was interested in astronomy from a young age. He received a telescope as a child and even founded an astronomy club at his high school. He received his PhD from Harvard in 1956, and his thesis was on yellow supergiants, just like me. He was specifically interested in variable yellow supergiants. These are stars whose brightnesses change over time. After receiving his PhD, Dr. Kameny taught astronomy for a year at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C., before being hired by the U.S. Army Map Services. There, he continued to use his astronomical skills to help measure the distances between continents using observations of the moon. As well, Dr. Kameny was really eager to participate in the U.S. space program, as the space race was starting to take off in 1955. However, during the 1950s in the United States, there was an era of moral panic known as McCarthyism. And as a part of this, gay men and lesbians were accused of being communists and therefore security threats. Homophobia was turned into a bureaucratic instrument, and thousands of LGBTQ people in the government and the military were persecuted and fired. In 1957, Dr. Kameny was questioned by his superiors at the U.S. Army Map Service about his sexual orientation, and when he refused to respond to questioning, he was fired and barred from ever holding a government position again. This upsetting and unjust event ended his career in astronomy. He never worked in the field again. However, it began a lifetime of activism for Dr. Kameny, who would go on to become one of the most influential figures in America's gay rights movement. It would be impossible to cover all of Dr. Kameny's achievements in just one video, so I'll just be talking about a few. He appealed his firing all the way to the Supreme Court, and although it wasn't successful, it was the first civil rights claim to be filed on the basis of sexuality in the United States. In 1961, he co-founded in Washington, D.C., one of America's first gay rights organizations. And this organization organized many gay rights protests, including a White House picket in 1965. In 1963, Dr. Kameny worked with other activists to get the American Psychiatric Association to cease classifying homosexuality as a mental disorder, and they were successful in 1974, only a decade later. Dr. Kameny worked to overturn DC's anti-gay laws. A bill that he personally drafted was passed into law in 1993, 30 years after he first wrote it. He was the first openly gay candidate for US Congress in 1971. He argued on live television in 1974 for the legalization of same-sex marriage, and he fought against employment discrimination for all of his life. In 2009, Dr. Kameny received a formal apology for the US government for his firing. And in 2010, he was at the front row in the Oval Office to witness the repealing of the law that prevented gay people from serving openly in the US military. And although Dr. Kameny passed away in 2011, the effects of his advocacy are still felt to this day. Gay marriage was legalized in the United States in 2015, and in 2020, the Supreme Court enshrined protections for LGBTQ employees into the Civil Rights Act. While Dr. Kameny never returned to astronomy, his observations of yellow supergiants still made lasting impacts on my field, and his impact as a gay rights advocate cannot be overstated. There were certainly many, many queer astronomers in the 1950s and onward who felt that they couldn't be their authentic selves due to fear of persecution. And it was because of the activism of people like Frank Kameny that many astronomers today, including myself, feel confident being their authentic selves. Happy Pride Month.